Diabolo in China. While the United States have their beloved yo-yo, China has something much more fun. And it works a little bit differently than your regular yo-yo. This toy called Diabolo is playing with two sticks connected to a string. The toy looks like a hollow barbell, and all you have to do is put the middle of the toy on the string, roll it on the ground, and make it spin. And that's where the fun begins. Just like the yo-yo, Diabolo is designed for all skill levels. You can just throw it in the air and catch it again with the string, or you can add some acrobatic movements while the toy is in the air. You can even have more than just one player and then pass the toy, or create unique routines. The options are endless, but it provides great fun for both children and adults. Diabolo tricks are so fascinating, they're commonly performed in various talent shows. You can find hundreds of clever ways to play with Diabolo, and of course, just like yo-yo, there are professional Diabolo tricksters out there. This toy was first discovered between 1386 and 1644 AD. Although it has gone through many changes, it remains one of the most popular toys in China. Hello Kitty from Japan. When it comes to popular toys around the world, Hello Kitty is the clear winner. There's no doubt that this small character managed to take over the world and create an impressive business empire. It all started in 1974, but back then Hello Kitty didn't even have a name yet. It was just a cute-looking character on a vinyl coin purse created by a Japanese designer. The Hello Kitty family started growing in 1976, and the public was introduced to her twin sister Minnie, Mom Mary, and Dad George. Here's a fun fact for you. Did you know that Hello Kitty actually owns a Persian cat as a pet? The Hello Kitty franchise took the world by storm. 4 years after the initial launch, the company started producing more and more Hello Kitty merchandise. In 1978, it expanded its products to Europe, starting with a Hello Kitty watch. It proved to be a success as over a million of these watches were sold. Just a little after, it made its first fashion debut with the Spring and Summer 2003 collection from Heatherette. In 2007, Hello Kitty even became a part of Macy's Thanksgiving Parade. People love Hello Kitty so much you can find Hello Kitty themed hotels, shops, and even cafes. Maria Ragdoll from Mexico. Mexico comes with a long history of making ragdolls, but they are some of the most popular toys you can find. They're called Marias, and they're also frequently sold in tourist venues. In fact, they're one of the most common symbols of Mexico for foreigners. They were created in the 1970s as a way to enhance more working opportunities for Otomi women. The Marias focus on representing traditional values of Mexico, but they became so popular they spread into various states. You can find many different versions of the Maria doll, but they all have the same face structure and braided hair, full of cute ribbons. These dolls are primarily made from clothing and various materials that are easily obtainable. Grandmothers and grandfathers usually made these dolls with their children to teach them about using different materials in order to create something unique. It is also believed that due to the materials used, these dolls are a symbol of connection with nature and other earth elements. The Marias are still influential, and in 2011, they were a part of a fashion event called A Tribute to Mexico, where many famous designers created their versions of the Marias. To make a rag doll, you'll need a few pieces of cloth, polyfill, thread, glue, pins, scissors, and a bit of creativity. Would you like to try making your own Maria rag doll? American Girl doll in the USA. Mattel, the company behind the famous Barbie, is behind the much-loved American Girl doll. Did you know that American Girl dolls are actually outselling Barbie dolls? Their history dates back to 1986, and much like Barbie dolls, American Girl dolls are on a mission to unleash young girls' full potential. Since 1986, over 30 million American Girl dolls were sold, and their catalog ranks as the largest consumer toy catalog in the country. So why are American Girl dolls so popular? Along with empowering and bringing confidence to little girls, American Girl dolls give voices to a diverse range of personalities and backgrounds. Their characters are inspiring and relatable, and they teach girls to make a difference. Along with contributing to many charities, American Girl doll characters explore the story behind the dolls. Their archives are full of historical characters like Caroline Abbott, Ruthie Smithens, and Kirsten Larson. Each come with a different historical problem they face and eventually overcome. The collection also extends to Girl of the Year dolls, with dolls like the 2003 Kaylee Hopkins, who learned to speak up for what she believed in and save the environment. There is an ongoing debate of which is better, the American Girl dolls or the Barbie doll. What do you think? Italian wooden toy cars. You've probably seen these around Italy. As much as they are a product for tourists, they are also beloved by Italian children. They were created by a company called Tubias, and the story behind these minimalistic-looking toys is quite unique. It all started with a designer who became a father and got tired of seeing his children using their toys for just a few hours before they got bored with them. He wanted to create something that has a deeper meaning than just playtime for a few hours. He wanted something that can have a recognizable smell that easily takes you back to your childhood even as you grow older. And that's how the 2BS toys started. All toys are made from strong and sweet-scented cedar wood, and they're made by incredibly talented designers who share the same vision. The motto is based on a belief that playing is a serious matter. All toy cars are made with sturdy and long-lasting material. These are the toys that are passed from generations to generations. And by not having any factory paint, it allows them to hold a timeless charm. Along with supporting children's charities, the company also supports future designers with their Wanna Be Us program. Rubik's Cube from Hungary. Although Rubik's Cubes are now popular all over the world, they were invented by an architecture professor from Hungary called Erno Rubik. He managed to create an object that wasn't supposed to be possible, a solid cube that twisted and turned without falling apart. The cube was designed to be an object of art. Little did Erno know that his invention would become one of the most popular toys in history. First, Rubik's Cubes were actually twice the weight of the ones you know today, and they went by the name Magic Cubes. But the toy still had a huge success in Hungary, and soon after, it took over the world. They were named Rubik's Cubes after a company that agreed to sell the toys outside of Hungary thought the Magic Cubes were too connected to witchcraft. Can you believe that by 1980, an estimated 400 million Rubik's Cubes were sold? The toy had its own TV show. It was featured in Hollywood movies, and it was a popular toy in almost every household. Did you know that the Rubik's Cube has its own competitive sport called speed cubing? And if you ever have trouble solving a Rubik's Cube, this should make you feel better. It took Erno Rubik over a month to solve his own puzzle, and he even thought it wasn't possible to solve it. Sunka from the Philippines. Sunka is a popular game from the Philippines. It was traditionally played by women and children, and it comes with a very interesting story. The game is usually played outdoors, as it comes with an odd superstition that a house could come crashing down if you ever play the game indoors. Sunka is played on a wooden board with 16 carved pits. You play it by moving shells or pebbles around those pits. The game is used to find out more about your life, and little girls often played it to see whether they will marry. So here's how you play it. Two players have to sit on each side of the game board, and they each have six or more pebbles they use as tokens. Each player will then take a row of small holes. In order to see who goes first, they throw the seeds in the air, and whoever catches the most goes first. The player then begins by dropping the tokens into the hole in a clockwise motion until they reach the big hole. They continue doing this until they drop all their pebbles. They can capture the other player's holes if the last pebble of the opponent lands on their side. The game ends when all seven pits or holes on one side are empty. Jumping Caps from Poland. Another popular board game comes from Poland. The Polish version of the name might be too difficult for us to pronounce, but luckily there is an English version. The Jumping Caps comes with a board with holes and a launcher. Each cap comes with a different color: blue, green, yellow, and red. You can also see the same colors on the board. The goal of the game is to correctly make the caps jump into their correct color. There's an added difficulty by awarding points. As you can see, there's only one red hole in the middle of the board, and it's worth 20 points. You also lose points if the cap falls into any of the other corner holes. But if a player accidentally drops their cap into yours, you get 20 more points. Players take 10 turns, and the winner is the player with the highest number of points. Sounds pretty simple, right? You'd be surprised just how intense this game could get. Just try imagining playing it with one of your competitive siblings who always wants to win. As the game grew in popularity, it came with different shapes to up the difficulty. You can find triangle boards as well as bigger or smaller boards depending on your preferred level. Playmobil from Germany. You've probably heard of Playmobil before, right? The popular toy collection was first created in Germany in 1974 and has since then become a childhood classic. 3 billion play figures have been produced, and 30 different play themes are distributed in approximately 100 countries worldwide. They're beloved toys by both children and adults, as they support quality play and higher value toys that can be used again and again. The first ever Playmobil figures created were a knight, a worker, workman and a Native American. And 2 years later, the company introduced first women figurines. Over the years, the figures changed in sizes and shapes, but the first character to ever receive a distinctive shape was the pirate character, who got a round belly in 1986. In 2011, Playmobil introduced a brand new range with an idea you can create your very own characters. And Playmobil is still going strong today. In 2015, the Martin Luther Playmobil figurine became one of the best-selling characters, and 34,000 figurines were sold in just 3 days. But Playmobil's success can only be compared to one other popular toy. Can you guess which it might be? We'll give you a hint. It has only 4 letters. Lego from Denmark. It's Lego. When Lego was first introduced in 1932, everything was created in a carpenter's workshop. Today, Lego is the third largest manufacturer of toys and one of the most popular toys from Denmark. What's amazing about Legos is that no matter how old the brick is, it would still fit on a Lego brick made decades after. Did you know that the name behind Lego actually has a very cool meaning? It was created by using the first 2 letters of Danish words, leg and gut, which means play well. Lego unleashes imagination, and you can combine 6 of the 8 stud Lego bricks in almost a billion of ways. 4 billion Lego figures have been made since 1978, and you can bet all your favorite Lego characters have their Lego figure. Lego's mission is to inspire and develop the builders of tomorrow, and it's safe to say they reached their goal. Some of the craziest Lego structures include the Kennedy Space Center, which is made of 750,000 Lego bricks. Many artists have introduced Lego to the art world and are now only making things from Legos. How cool is that? Lego even has its own amusement park, made of 20 million bricks. It's one of Denmark's biggest tourist attractions.